very young, impressionable, and scared about the possibility of going to a war. We were all approaching the age we had to register for the draft. Back then there was a draft. Christmas holidays in 1966, that we'd gone to a Christmas party, and a guy who had graduated in 1965 had gone to Vietnam. He was there, and he was in a wheelchair, and he was missing both legs and an arm because of a mine. And it was a real wake-up call to sit there at a party and see a guy you had seen just a little over a year before walking around the campus where his body was torn and tattered from the experience of that war. The guy I went to school with, his name is on the Vietnam Wall, Mike Crow. Best man at my wedding and my best friend in high school, Mike Norton, went to Vietnam, and he was changed forever.
Let's have a report from our correspondent, Dan, rather in Dallas, that he has confirmed that President Kennedy is dead.
When John F. Kennedy was assassinated, I was in class at Andress High School. I remember it was November of 1963. I don't know the exact date, but it was a surreal moment. It's like the whole world stopped spinning. That drugs were totally foreign to us at Andrews. Now, when I enrolled at UTEP, that was in fall of 1967, and the psychedelic era was just starting to kick off, and it became very prevalent. In fact, a good friend of my wife and I, and she was a cheerleader along with my wife at Andrews, died of a drug overdose. She got caught up into that drug culture. But I can tell you, when at Andrews, it was, you never saw it, you never heard of it in the early 60s, up until 67 we graduated. Had Coach Zepkowitz for physiology. He had a lot more hair. His glasses weren't as thick as they are today. It seemed like he lost more hair and the lenses got thicker. But he was an incredible guy.
Mr. Holland, we would now like to give something back to you and to your wife, who along with you has waited 30 years for what we're about to hear. If you will, would you please come up here and take this baton and lead us in the first performance ever of the American Symphony by Glenn Holland.
I really wasn't going to get into coaching. I had visions of, in fact, really wanted to be a pediatrician, but I wasn't quite smart enough to be a pediatrician. I was originally assigned to a different school. JW got the head job here. He asked me to come along with him. I came here in 65, and here we are 2010.
And I think that the 50th reunion will even bring more people together so that we can learn about each other and experience joy in what we have achieved in life. The average longevity of a teacher nowadays is 5 years. If you can keep someone in the profession for 5 years, that's considered quite good. If you're going to stay for a lifetime, well, then, for the best years of your life, then you must have a lot of extra activities that you do.
Somebody says, "Who's that idiot up on that tower yelling?" It was me. Bobby Ortega, that's when I didn't know him when he was a student at Andress, but he used to tell me that when he heard the band start playing at 7, it was time for him to get up and go to school.
The paddle of education, or the swats back then, I got swatted, I believe, once from a coach. But I never told my father about those swats. He asked me, "What's wrong with your limping?" And I just wouldn't say anything, because I knew if I told him, then he would take care of me at home too. So that's how much respect our parents had for these educators back then, coaches too.
My final thought would be that it's a very, very competitive world. Today we're going to have a lot of people that will be flipping hamburgers, which is not a derogatory comment, but if you are going to be successful, you are going to have to pressure yourself to get an education, and you're going to have to pressure yourself to continue learning. Don't ever stop learning. Don't ever stop learning.
People have adapted, you know, youth adapted to whatever the situation is, what the circumstances are, and if we've had to make some adjustments in our life, we've made those adjustments, and our generations going back, I think, have made adjustments better than the people of today have made adjustments, and I think that we've done all right for ourselves. Going back, us old guys, you know, have done all right for ourselves and been able to make the adjustments and maybe moved into the modern. I'm not gonna say it's a modern, but it's a changing world all the time, and if you don't adjust, then what happens to you? Well, you just kind of fall by the wayside.
When I first arrived at Andress 1 year ago, one of the first things that struck me was the rich tradition here at Andress High School. I can't tell you how many alumni and community members that have graduated from Andress that I have run into here within the district and within the community. And I was just struck by the pride and the spirit that they still have about Andress High School, and it gave me a sense of awe of the rich history of the school.
It's not a my team, it's not a my guard, it's not a my fullback, it's an our fullback, it's an our school. We're all in this together, you know. It's not me against them, it's not me against whoever, it's us, it's our football team, it's our school. And that's been our school for now going on 46 years, and It's been a good ride for myself. We hope we've touched enough lives in a positive direction that as we finish off this career, that we can always look back and say we made a difference as far as Andress High School.
The dates of the event are, the primary one is gonna be Saturday, July 23rd at the El Paso Convention Bureau at the Civic Center. The event will go from 5 p.m. to 12 midnight. We're certain there will be other parties going on after that. Most of the folks we understand are going to be arriving Thursday, or is it the 20th of July, whatever day that turns out to be, Wednesday, Thursday. And we've already got some classes doing events on Thursday evening, Friday evening. We have a golf tournament that's going to happen on that Friday morning. Likely it's going to be at Painted Dunes. We will also have a family event that's going to be held at likely at the Diablos Baseball Park. I think it's called Cohen Stadium these days. And that's out in Northeast El Paso, and that's gonna be that next Sunday. Plenty of opportunities for you to connect with your class, with a group of classes, but most importantly, the big celebration will be on Saturday evening.
So many people have come and gone. The faces fade as the years go by. Yet I still recall, as I walk around.